delegates of this historic convention, greetings from the beautiful island of Jamaica. ASI Jamaica is very pleased to present this brief report of its work in Jamaica over the past year. Jamaica is strategically located in the Caribbean Sea and is the largest English-speaking island in the region. Our population stands at over 2.7 million persons, and the Seventh-day Adventist Church is the single largest religious group on our island. Our current membership is over 300,000 members, worshiping in some 750 congregations. We operate one university, Northern Caribbean University, one hospital, Andrews Memorial, and 24 high and preparatory schools. The Seventh-day Adventist Church is highly respected both in the corporate society as well as the local community. ASI Jamaica comprises five active chapters in which many of our members utilize their businesses as mission agencies. The growth and strength of the Seventh-day Adventist Church in Jamaica can be attributed to a large degree to our members who operate various businesses and/or professionals who serve in the public and private sectors. Under the leadership of Mrs. Judy Morgan, ASI Jamaica has been a beacon of light, giving hope to the hopeless and providing food, comfort, help, and empowerment both to church members and the wider society. ASI Jamaica is undergirded by a strong prayer ministry team led by Brother Lascelles Davis. Members of this team meet quarterly in designated churches across the five fields to pray for the nation and the mission of the church. The Good Samaritan Inn and public campus ministries constitute the central focus of the ASI in the eastern region of the island, under the leadership of Mr. Cecil Foster. The Good Samaritan Inn, the flagship of ASI Jamaica, celebrated 10 years of service to humanity on December 23, 2017, and continues to make an impact as people are ministered to daily, reflecting the ministry of Christ. From its humble beginning, serving 50 lunches to homeless people in Kingston, the capital of the island, the ministry of the Good Samaritan Inn has expanded and now offers the following: cooked meals 4 days weekly, bathroom and toilet facilities for daily use, laundry facilities also for daily use, distribution of clothing and shoes, response to critical needs overnight accommodation for ladies, annual back-to-school assistance in the months of August and September, annual Christmas fun day for children in the community, a site for students in secondary and tertiary institutions to do their community work or practicum, annual visit by various Ivy League universities in the United States, and dental and medical care in a modern health center. To date, thousands of clients have benefited from the services of the Good Samaritan Inn. Many have come to know the Lord as their personal Savior, and millions of dollars have been donated in medical and dental supplies and services. All services provided at the inn are free to the public. ASI and public tertiary campuses in Jamaica have been working together to preach Christ in the marketplace. Since 2016, ASI has partnered with both the Jamaica Union and East Jamaica Conference in undertaking the following: welcoming new students to their college and university campuses and giving them the opportunity to identify with the church and church members in their unique environment, offering mentorship to students in different fields of study, helping to finance their on-campus fraternity campus days, and providing financial support to needy students. On September 23, 2017, over 350 students from the various Adventist public campuses assembled at the Andrews SDA Church in Kingston to be welcomed to their campuses for the new school year. The sermon for the day was presented by Pastor Dane Fletcher, Youth Director of the Jamaica Union Conference. Among the campuses participating were the University of the West Indies Advent Fellowship, Shortwood Teachers College, University of Technology, Michael University, Northern Caribbean University, College of Agriculture, Science and Education, Caribbean Maritime University, and the Sam Sharp Teachers College. Immediately after the church service at Andrews Seventh-day Adventist Church, students were transported to King's House, where they were welcomed by His Excellency Sir Patrick Allen, Governor General of Jamaica. At King's House, students participated in a lively Sabbath school lesson, followed by a panel discussion. The panelists included Sir Patrick Allen, Professor Alvin Wint, and the President of Advent Fellowship for the University of the West Indies. ASI also supported chapel days at the following tertiary institutions: Maiko University, Advent Fellowship at the University of the West Indies, and Shortwood Teachers College. On the average, 300 students were present at all the Chapel Day services. ASI and 10 university students also carried out workday at Open Arms, an institution in Kingston which provides shelter and food primarily for deported men. The North and Northeast chapters of ASI, under the leadership of Mrs. Pancetta Beam and Dr. Kirkland, were very engaged in sharing Christ in the marketplace. After inspiring and motivating local chapter conventions, the leaders undertook several community outreach initiatives. These include distributing care packages for individuals, as well as the Mustard Seed Home for the Disabled and the Pringles Girls Home, where each month the girls are mentored, care packages are distributed, and the girls are engaged in indoor games. Visiting and ministering to persons who needed medical services in organized clinics were also important aspects of the ASI work in this region. Dr. Kirkland, a medical doctor and the president for the Northeast chapter, gave leadership to this initiative. The chapters also partnered with the youth through the Global Youth Day program to provide food and water to needy persons. Business and professional persons in the Central and West chapters were deeply engaged in sharing Christ in the marketplace. These chapters are led by Mrs. Yvette Scott and Mr. Dennis Samuels, respectively. In Central, the chapter leaders partnered with the Global Youth Day program and provided care packages to a children's home. The chapter also assisted in creating additional classrooms for a school in the Chedwin community, while the Three Angels Mobile Clinic conducted clinics in three communities, in which they not only ministered to the health needs of residents, but also gave out copies of The Great Controversy.
Among the many individuals who have been impacting lives here in our island is Mr. Rohan McNally, a Seventh-day Adventist who has harnessed his resources and is impacting lives. Through his mobile clinic, he has been going from parish to parish and has been helping individuals to recognize that Jesus still has helping hands.
The Seventh-day Adventist Christian, you see all these, you read all these missionary stories, you kind of realize what the Christian ought to be doing. And I think after a while, sitting in church and realizing that, there's a need to go out there and meet some people and share the message, coupled with the fact that I've been one who knew what it was not to have. The Lord has really blessed me, and out of that I realized, you know what, I felt incomplete. So I decided that, you know, there's something I need to do, prayed about it, and then the Lord has put this in my heart, give me this idea. It has a multiple effect. I mean, we could partner with government agencies, become first responders in tragedies, and as I keep thinking about it, I said, you know, Lord, if you ever bless me with the means, I'm going to do it. And after 10 years in business, I said to myself, you know what, I've seen where the Lord has led me, and I decided to put it into practice. Over the year, at the anniversary, we would have covered over 60 communities in Jamaica, 10 parishes, touched over 6,000 lives. But I can tell you the truth, that right as we speak, this second year has started much busier than our first year. And thus far, I think we probably have gone maybe close to another 1,000 already since our anniversary.
In the West, the Business and Professional Leaders Convention continues to provide a great vehicle not only for promoting businesses and services, but to provide a medium for sharing Christ in the marketplace. ASI Jamaica is very strong. All chapters in the union are now working with the union in preparing some major health and community outreach projects for national impact between now and early 2019.
We look forward to even greater partnership as we prepare for Mission Impact 2019, during which we are hoping to impact many communities, over 500 mission projects we want to undertake across our nation, during which we hope to, through health, through community outreach, help men and women to come to recognize that God cares about them and He cares through His people. We will also be looking forward to having over 500 reaping campaigns. We look forward to your working with us.
Continue to pray for Jamaica as together we partner in sharing Christ in the marketplace and thereby transforming lives in the preparation of our Lord's imminent return.
On behalf of Pastor Everett Brown and the other administrators of Jamaica Union Conference, I wish to register profound gratitude to to all our ASI leaders and members here in Jamaica. You have been doing a fantastic work in transforming the lives of men and women in the community. May God bless you as we partner together to advance the mission and to share Christ in the marketplace.